decimal numbers. You went to the grocery store today and checked on the snack shelves. Then you saw changes in the price of your favorite chocolate. Have a look at these numbers, 25 and then 24.998. The former is chocolate's initial price and the latter is its current price. So which one is the decimal number? Decimals are defined as fractions, which have denominators with powers of 10. In a decimal form, there will be a decimal point indicating the place value of the numeral in a whole number. Remember that power of 10 is the multiplication of 10 by itself, such as 10, 100, or 1000, and can be represented as 10 to the power n, whereas n is a factor of multiplication. Let's take 24.998. By definition, we know that decimal numbers are fractions with denominators that have powers of 10. Now, to convert this decimal into a fraction, you need to remember a thumb rule. The decimal point is placed at a specific position, exactly to the right of the unit position of the whole number. In the case of 24.998, it is placed exactly to the right of 4. Once you remove the decimal, the number will be divided by powers of 10 equal to the number of spaces after the decimal point, counting from the left, that is, 3. The fraction in the answer can further be simplified by dividing both the numerator and the denominator by a common divisor. In this problem, the common divisor is 2. When 24,998 is divided by 2, we get 12,499. When the denominator 1,000 is divided by 2, we get 500. Since these numbers cannot be commonly divided further, then this is the simplest fraction. Now it is your turn to do the conversion from decimal to fraction. Convert 2.25 to a fraction. You can pause the video, have a go, and then resume the video to see the problem-solving process. First, we will count the number of spaces after the decimal point, counting from the left. The number of spaces is 2. Therefore, once we remove the decimal, the number will be divided by 10 to the power 2. So, 2.25 equals 225 over 100 equals 9 over 4. 9 over 4 is obtained when we simplify 225 over 100 by dividing both the numerator and the denominator with a common divisor of 25. Did you forget to give your answer in the simplest form? If yes, remember, it is always better to write a fraction in its simplest form. Let's go back to the grocery store. As an exercise, and to make sure that you master the thumb rule of the math way, convert some of these decimal prices into fractions. We hope that you find it easy to convert the decimals into fractions. This is only the beginning. In the next video, we will uncover more about decimals. So, how was your answer? Let us know in the comments below.